Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me today is Tom Equels, CEO at AIM ImmunoTech. Tom, good to see you. How are you today?
Hey, great. Good to see you again, Christine.
Tom, it has been a while since we last spoke, so lots to discuss today. Let's first kick it off with how your drug Ampligen has been featured in a peer-reviewed medical journal called Cancers. What do the authors have to say about Ampligen?
Well, the article was done on a parallel, the research that is the basis for the article was done on a parallel track with the major study that we've done in pancreatic cancer at Erasmus University Medical Center in the Netherlands, and it's located in Rotterdam. And principal author is the principal investigator in that study is Professor Dr. C.H.J. Van Eyck. And Professor Van Eyck wanted to utilize Ampligen in the pancreatic cell line to better understand the mechanism of action of Ampligen in these pancreatic cells, as well as challenges against SARS-CoV-2, which is the virus that caused the COVID-19. And it provides us some insights, very important insights, and in a very positive light about how Ampligen actually works to stimulate the immune system so as to both have an antiviral, and we believe it, there's some level of extrapolation anti-tumor effect. You may recall the pancreatic cancer study was part of an early access program conducted in the Netherlands at Erasmus Medical Center, one of the premier, the preeminent pancreatic cancer research center in Europe. By Professor Van Eyck. And there we had tremendous results in terms of survival compared to the standard of care in late stage, locally advanced and metastatic pancreatic cancers. So this is part of an overall program that we've been working on. The data and the article related to that study in the Netherlands, specifically in pancreatic cancer, as a result, with regards to the human subjects and their extended survival, will be published, we believe, in the near future by Professor Van Eyck in an important journal, as well as was the basis for the regulatory filings we did both in Europe and the United States, seeking orphan drug designation, which requires an analysis of both safety and efficacy of the human data as they look at those applications.
And as you said, obviously the drug is being studied in the Netherlands. You have received a patent in the Netherlands. So what does it cover?
Well, the patent in the Netherlands is a little bit different than what we're doing in, you know, I was talking about in pancreatic cancer, which was Ampligen as a sole agent fighting pancreatic cancer. And we did get the orphan drug designations from both the United States and the EMA, which gives us market exclusivity, significant periods of market exclusivity, which is similar to what a patent does, only it's in a way it's even better because it's not subject to even challenges and stuff. If you have the orphan drug designation, you have far fewer chances for somebody to try and interfere with your use and your market exclusivity. But we also have been developing utility patents in a number of areas as a part of our drug development program. The patent that just issued in the Netherlands is a part of that program. It's a utility patent for Ampligen as a combination therapy with a wide variety of immunological anti-cancer oncology, immuno-oncology agents. And that would be like, for example, Ampligen plus Keytruda as a therapy. And the background behind that is that Ampligen will have an important role to play in helping other immunotherapies work, because many of these cancers are so deadly and so difficult to treat because they're immunosilent. Oncologists use the slang terms cold tumor versus hot tumor. A cold tumor is a tumor that the immune system can't see and doesn't respond to. A hot tumor is one that the immune system does see and attacks. Many of these immunotherapies function similar to the immune system in general. So if the immune system can't see the tumor, there's a possibility that the checkpoint blockade drug can't see the tumor, you know, and interact with the tumor to kill the tumor. So Ampligen takes down, we believe that we'll be able to show long-term that Ampligen takes down the camouflage on this tumor in a wide spectrum of solid tumors, so as to allow other immunotherapies to be more effective.
And now I do want to get an update on your intranasal therapy. From my understanding, you have recently finished dosing cohort 3 in your phase 1. So what did you find here?
Well, this is a phase 1 intranasal safety study in humans. It's being conducted at Leiden University complex in the Netherlands. It's not at Erasmus, but it's at a different Dutch university. And the Center for Human Drug Research is our CRO that's conducting the study in Leiden. Now, what we're trying to accomplish, and we believe we're making, you know, very positive progress. You can see every cohort that's finished, once we have the data, we've announced the data, is to show that Ampligen can be safely administered at escalating doses with very high frequency in the nose without causing any problems to the human subjects. Now, thus far, we've had 3 cohorts without any significant adverse events. We have a schedule that we're on. We're still on schedule. All of the subjects in the fourth cohort have finished their treatments, but we don't have all the data for the fourth cohort yet. But we expect to be announcing the results of that fourth cohort soon. And if it's similar to the prior 3, it'll mean that in all of the different possible dosage levels that we think might be appropriate for Ampligen intranasally, that Ampligen is generally well tolerated. But we'll have to wait for that data on the fourth cohort, which is the highest dosage level, to come out. Now you may ask, well, why are we doing this? There are a number of diseases where a drug like Ampligen, which activates innate immune system pathways that are antiviral, anti-tumor, anti-inflammatory pathways, might be beneficial if you could apply it intranasally. So let's just talk about what's on everybody's mind. You know, everybody wants to talk about COVID-19. But COVID-19 is based on the SARS-CoV-2 virus, which is simply a respiratory virus. We believe that, and we intend to test in humans in the near future, the proposition that Ampligen will be able to prevent infection if administered prior to or immediately after exposure for a wide variety of respiratory viruses, such as the common cold, influenza, SARS. And the application of this from a public health standpoint could be far-reaching. Why is that? The reason is, I don't mean to be doing your job, so forgive me for asking my own questions.
That's okay.
The reason is that first of all, we have a list of known respiratory viruses, which cause tremendous public health problems. And almost in every instances, those viruses come in through the nose or the mucosal surfaces associated with the sinuses, and the sinus system. So an intranasal spray of Ampligen brings the Ampligen to the surfaces of that system, creating an activation. Ampligen's a toll-like receptor 3 agonist. These surfaces are rich with toll-like receptor 3 receptors. So an activation of the immune system right where the virus comes in. So this is why we think it's important as an antiviral. And it's not just for known viruses. You know, one of the problems we had with COVID-19 is nobody had ever seen it before. Right? But it works like every other respiratory virus. It's just that to do a vaccine or a therapy, oftentimes you have to identify the virus, and it takes a significant amount of time to prepare a vaccination program. But if we have something that has the opportunity to work equally well, whether it's the common cold, common influenza, some kind of more serious lethal influenza, or a SARS virus, if we're able to show that Ampligen can do that, we then fill an unmet medical need, an unmet public health need, because when that virus outbreaks, let's say it's a variant or a mutation of an existing virus that we don't have a vaccine for, we have something that we can use in hospitals, on cruise ships and commercial airplanes and gatherings that will help people in addition to their personal protective equipment like masks and so forth. It's sort of like would act as a mask from the inside out, so that if you did get exposed, you have an increased chance of not getting infected. So that's the idea behind it. Now, how does it apply? We hope, if we're successful in our phase 2 work, that we'll be able to demonstrate that Ampligen could have a role to play on cruise ships, on commercial airline flights, and military ships, on military installations where troops are in close quarters, in families where if one family member becomes infected with a respiratory virus, especially if it's a serious one, you know, the other family members have an opportunity to care for the sick person, even though there may not be a vaccine available, at the same time, blunting the likelihood that they get infected. So these are all important public health issues that our intranasal program is designed to answer the question, can Ampligen do this? But we have to start with, is it safe? So we're rapidly moving through that, and we're in the planning stages for the phase 2 part of this, where we test the efficacy of our proposition that Ampligen serves as a prophylactic, as a preventative for a range of respiratory viruses.
Appreciate the explanation here. We'll look forward to the cohort 4 data. Tom, thanks again.
Well, Christine, it's always a pleasure, and thank you very much for your interest and for the interest of the proactive team and your audience out there.